that they call the Gazette. Who balances things on top of his head, 'cause it's flat? Or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat? Or a sort of a, kind of a, hat-loving cat? I can see you've got quite the mind for your age. Why, one thing, can you drag me right onto the stage? Now I'm here, there's no telling what may ensue. Cats such as me, and a thinker like you. All the things you can think, all the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible beak, or a geek with a stick, or a stare to the sky.
Now think of an elephant lumbering through. discuss. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear that a blow in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I just have to save him because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
Talk about me.
Talk about me.
Talk about me.
Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Talk about me. Tal
She knew to approach him would probably fail, 'cause who noticed a bird with a long feathered tail? Help! Help!
Then he heard it again, calling over and over.
Help!
So he tried to think, who might be down that clover? An invisible world, amazing but true.
And guess who now enters our story?
Who?
You!
Hello? Is anyone there? Who are you?
Well, we're Hoot. We are Hoots. You're smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. We're Hoots. Hoots. Maybe so.
today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You've invented new things which defy all description.
You gave Miss O'Dooley a nervous connection.
Your things were so wild, they disrupted your classes, which made Miss McElroo drop her new glasses. Which is why you're suspended.
Yes, that's what they said.
Young lady, what in who has gotten to your head? Now Horton has found us. We're safe on Clover, but clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We love you.
Oh yes, dear.
But couldn't you try thinking just a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take a bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble! Get out of the way!
Alright. I'll be going. Bye.
But first, let me say.
Oh, stop, you can think. I'm not listening.
As you splash and you splish. As you sit there and scrub, have been thinking that too. Think of
water and fish.
Fish.
Think of pipes in the floor, leading you to a shore where the water is cool. Swimming tub, not a tub,
it's McElegant's pool. This might be a pool, like I've read in the books, connected to one of those underground brooks. And under that river that starts to get close, we're under this bathtub, and then who knows is possible.
guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck could speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, tiny planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing as well.
and she had the smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she dyed it, she gave it a puff, she decked it with flowers, but it wasn't enough.
What's a blanker to do? And there's certainly nothing so offish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have a cake. So I went to the doctor.
Dr. David Clay.
And he told me what sort of pill I should take. Now
yes, it will. One more pill.
seatbelt, kid, because now things go wrong.
Oh,
feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton. Horton together, we could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton. Put down the clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf. Your neighbor's from Dover. Over and over, clover, white clover. I was just a no one.
Carefully, tenderly, gently. you, Row. Was anything different?
Yes, it's getting colder.
Thank you.
Good luck. And goodbye.
I meant what I said. Yeah, I said what I meant. The elephant's faithful. 100%.
Who's there?
It's me, Gertrude. Horton, oh,
tail was too heavy for normal flying. So I ran to the doctor, a doctor named Dick, and she said,
"My tail has a bit of a sting," and she said, "Dr. Dick, I have a foolish name. Pluck it out. Cut it off. I won't do it again." Look, look, look.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Look, look, look.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Look, look, look. Just a one feather tail. But suddenly, Gertrude could sail.
I sailed up and jumped and was gradually sunk.
Yeah! evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant.
Yeah!